गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट गेट रिलेटेड टॉपिक, गेट क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टॉपिक्स। दिस इज वेरी यूजफुल स्कीम फॉर प्रिपेरिंग एससी एसटी स्टूडेंट्स फॉर हायर एजुकेशन अंडर एसीटी श्रीराणा स्कीम। लेट मी डिस्कस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट केमिकल प्रोसेस इंडस्ट्रीज। द सेशन इज पेट्रोलियम पेट्रोकेमिकल इंडस्ट्रीज। रिसोर्स पर्सन मई सेल्फ टी उषाराणी, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग, ईरोड सेंगुंदर इंजीनियरिंग College, Tamil Nadu. Today, I'm going to discuss about the topic petroleum and petrochemical industries. In this, there are many subtopics are there. In that, first one is crude classification, chemical composition, petroleum, refinery products, petroleum conversion process, that are pyrolysis, cracking, reforming, polymerization, isomerization, and alkalization. Petrochemicals, that is methanol, chloromethanol, acetylene and ethylene, isopropanol, acrylonitrile, butadiene. And then next one, chemical from aromatics, that are benzene, toluene and xylene. Maybe sometimes it is asked as BTX. So next, what is petroleum? In this, some of the objective type questions come, maybe it comes in, come for gate related questions. In that, what is petroleum? Petroleum is a complex mixture of hydrocarbon that occur in the sedimentary rock in the form of gases, that is natural gas. Liquids, it is called as crude oil. Semi-solid means it is bitumen. For solid means it's wax or asphalt. Then next, what is the petroleum is another name. Where it is derived? It means the word petroleum, it derived from the Latin words petra and oleum. It means literally it is called as rock oil, and special type of oil is called oleum. Petroleum is the raw material for many chemical products, including pharmaceutical solvents, fertilizer, pesticides, and plastics. This is the major use for petroleum, used as a raw material. Next, this flow sheet discuss about basic refinery concept. What is the product we are recovering the crude oil to intermediate product, and that intermediate product it convert into chemical conversion process occurring. In that we are obtaining final products. So let me discuss about what is refinery process. So refinery process means the crude oil is extracting from underground, and then that is heated in the using furnace, and then it passed to crude distillation column and vacuum distillation column. What is the difference between crude distillation column and vacuum distillation column? Means crude distillation column is it present in the atmospheric air. In vacuum distillation column is we are removing that air. Under vacuum, the boiling is low temperature, the boiling will take place. This is the difference for these two. On crude distillation, there are many intermediate products that we are obtaining, and vacuum distillation also. What are that means? Based on the boiling point. So less than 90 degree Fahrenheit means the hydrocarbons are C1 to C4 is appear. That is intermediate products are propane, butane and lighter hydrocarbons. What are the chemical conversion processes we are using to increase the value of that intermediate product to final product? That is light in recovery and cracking process, cracking conversion processes of using, we can obtain the final product as a refinery fuel gas, propane and natural gas liquids. And the next temperature is 92 to 220 Fahrenheit, means C5 to C8. The intermediates are light virgin naphtha, the low octane value, that is increased octane. The high octane value means we can use the isomerization and blending process, that is the conversion process, to obtain the final product as a gasoline. Next, third one is 220 to 350 degree Fahrenheit. Heavy naphtha, heavy virgin naphtha we are obtaining as intermediate product, that is a conversion process will take place, reforming and blending, we can obtain the final product as a gasoline, jet fuel, petrochemicals. Next, 315 to 450 Fahrenheit means C12 to C30 as a product we can obtain intermediate as a kerosene. That kerosene is hydrotreated, conversion process is taking place, we can obtain the kerosene, jet fuel, diesel and fuel oil. And then next, 450 to 650 Fahrenheit, we can obtain the hydrocarbon as C30 to C50 plus. In that intermediate product, as a diesel, light gas oil, hydrotreater. The conversion process, what the conversion process will taking place in this process means hydrotreater and hydrocracker. That is, the final product is gasoline diesel fuel oil. And the vacuum distillation column, we can obtain the hydrocarbon is C32C plus, C50 plus. The temperature range is C650 to 800 degree Fahrenheit. That is, the intermediate product is heavy gas oil. The conversion process is fluid catalytic cracking, that is also called as FCC, and hydrocracking also takes place. We can obtain the final product as gasoline, diesel, and fuel oil. The last vacuum distillation unit product as 800 degree Fahrenheit, we can obtain C50 to C100 hydrocarbon. We can obtain the intermediate product as residual fuel oil as asphalt. What conversion process will taking place means coker and resid hydrocracking. In that conversion process takes place, we can obtain the final product as gasoline, diesel, fuel oil, and lube rocks. Next, the origin, occurrence, and formation of petroleum. Some of the questions coming in this topic, we can coming for GATE. So listen carefully. Petroleum occurs in the earth crust in all possible states and virgin in color from light brown to dark brown or black. You note down this point is very important. So, sometimes may be asked for GATE. It is a mixture of various hydrocarbon and occurs mostly in sedimentary rocks. Petroleum is a term that includes a wide variety of liquid hydrocarbons. Many scientists also include natural gas in the definition of petroleum. The most familiar types of petroleum are tar, oil, and natural gas. The petroleum forms through the accumulation of viral and formation of transformation of organic material such as remains of plants and animals by chemical, geological, biological changes over a long period of time. What it is anaerobic or aerobic? The condition is anaerobic condition. There are several theories of formation of petroleum, inorganic theories, organic theories. The formation of petroleum. Most of the world's oil and gas is made up of fossil remains of microscopic marine plants and animals. That's why oil and gas are often referred to as a fossil fuel. One of the most important group of plankton involved in the formation of oil and gas are single celled marine plants called dinoflagellates. Through many types of animal plankton are also important. Some oil and gas may have also originated from the remains of land plants. In certain parts of the world's oceans, plankton occurs in enormous quantities of blooms. Exactly where those plankton blooms occur in controlled by ocean currents. Deepest part of the ocean, the nutrients found in these upwelling zones feed plankton and allow them to produce quickly. A single liter of seawater may contain several million dinoflagellates. Where this plankton occurs in higher number of, they may turn the water red. The phenomena is called as red tide. Sometimes this type of questions may ask for GATE. We note it down. When plankton dies, it slowly settles to seabed where it forms an organic mass. Usually there are a lot of animals living on the sea floor that feed on this material. However, under certain conditions, there may be very little oxygen on sea floor. This may be because of the ocean is deep and stagnant and oxygen has not been mixed down the surface waters. No animal life can survive where the seabed is completely lacking oxygen. Without animals to eat the dead plankton, the organic mass builds up of the seabed where ocean sediment contains more than 5% organic mass. It evenly forms a rock known as black shale. This also note down, it is very important. It may be sometimes asked GATE. The black color comes from the dark organic matter that it contains. Elemental composition of petroleum. In general, for petroleum oils, it appears that the compositions of elements vary within fairly narrow limits. On a weight basis, there are carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, sulfur, metals, nickel. What metals are? Nickel, vanadium, and copper. It is less than 100,000 ppm. Carbon, the notation is C. the range is 83 to 87%. Hydrogen H, the rotation is H, 10 to 14%. Nitrogen 0.1 to 2%. Oxygen 0.05 to 1.5%. Sulfur it contains 0.05 to 6%. The metals like nickel, vanadium, and copper, it less than 100,000 ppm. The range is 0.1%. Next, what is the elemental composition of petroleum? These are very important. We note it down for maybe sometimes also forget this type of questions. We note it down. Sulfur. Sulfur is found in the crude in variable amounts. Usually, sulfur compounds are present in more molecular weight stocks. The amount of sulfur in crude may vary from 0.05 to 1% or 6% by weight. Usually, sulfur content does not exceed 5%. So, however, rare exception, the Venezuela crude. Venezuela crude, it contains 5.25% sulfur. Otherwise, our maximum the crude oil we are obtaining from the earth, it is less than 5%. In the California, USA, 5.21%. Ina rain is 7%, etc. crudes. Sulfur in the crude occurs in different forms like free sulfur, hydrogen sulfide, mercaptans, and theopompes, etc. Sulfur is the most important hydroatom in petroleum, and it can be found in cyclic as well as non-cyclic compounds such as mercaptans. The notation is RSH. And sulfides RSW, where R and R dash are alkyl groups. Sulfur in natural gas is usually found in the form of hydrogen sulfides, H2S. Some natural gases contain H2S as a high as 30% by volume. The presence of sulfur in finished petroleum product is harmful. For example, the presence of sulfur in gasoline can promote corrosion of the engine parts. Oxygen and nitrogen. Oxygen and nitrogen do not occur in free state. We note it down. This is very important one word answer. For sometimes it may be asked for gate. In petroleum crude or in fractions, oxygen occurs in oxygenated compounds like phenols, cerals, naphthalenes, acids, sulfonates, and sulfates. Nitrogen exists in the form of pyridine, quinoline, and amines. Usually below, what is the percentage? It present in crude oil means usually below 2%. Catalytic deactivation and gum formation are some effects of nitrogen present in crude. So nitrogen is present in that crude means catalytic deactivation also it occur, and gum formation also formed in that oil separation process. So heavy metal. The metal content of crude oil can vary from few parts of the million to more than 1000 ppm, and in spite of the relatively low concentrations or the considerable importance, minute quantities of some of these metals like nickel, vanadium, and copper can severely affect the activities of catalyst and result in the lower value product distribution. Vanadium concentrations of over 2 ppm in fuel oils can lead to serve corrosion in turbine blades and deterioration of refractory in furnaces. The metallic content may be reduced by solvent extraction with organic solvent. Then next, what is the chemical composition? So in open chain or aliphatic compounds, N-paraffin series, isoparaffin series, olefin paraffin series. There are the three series are available for open or aliphatic compounds. In ring or cyclic compounds, there are two. One is naphthalene series, another one is aromatic or benzoyl series. Last one is asphalt series. It is asphaltenes or resinous. So what is open chain or aliphatic compounds? First one is N-paraffin series. CnH2n+2. The series of hydrocarbons comprises a larger fraction of most petroleum than any of the other individual classes. The N-paraffins predominate in most state-run gasolines. Isoparaffin series, CnH2n+2. The branched chain compounds are very desirable and are frequently manufactured by hydroforming, alkalization, and isomerization. Then next, olefin series. CnH2n, this series is not present or exists in a very small quantities. Cracking process produces large amount of olefins. Olefins are very useful because they are excellent. Anti-knock properties and chemical reactivities, it is very important. All of you noted down, this type of questions may ask in GATE. Note it down. Next, the olefin or most important class of component chemically derived from petroleum for the making of other products also by chemical processing or conversion. Then next, ring or cyclic compound. First one is naphthalene series, CnH2n. This series, which has the name type formula as a olefin series, differs in that it is members are completely saturated. It is the second most abundantly occurring series of components in most crudes. These naphthalenes predominates in most gas oil and lubricating oil from all types of crudes. These also present in residual products. Aromatic or benzoid series, CnH2n plus 6. Only small amount of aromatic compounds are present in most petroleums. These compounds are produced by chemical processing and, like the olefins, have high anti-knock qualities, good storage stability. The next, asphalt. The complex materials of relatively low value consisting of colloids of asphalt and resins. Asphalt is brownish black solid, soluble in aromatics but not in paraffins. Chemically composed of CH with the appreciable quantities of SON resins. Highly aggressive brown semi-solid of low molecular weight than asphalt is, but similar chemical composition. The chemical composition, there are four. One is paraffin, naphthalene, aromatics, aliphatics, asphaltics. So paraffin, the average is 30%, range is 15 to 60%. Naphthalene 49%, 30 to 60%. Aromatics 15%, 3 to 30%. Asphaltics 6%, the remaining. All of you noted down this type of ranges may be asked for gate questions. Next, crude classification. Crude may be classified as the many types that are. The general classification of petroleum is based on the paraffinic content present in the residue. The paraffinic base, mixed base or intermediate base, naphthalenic base, the paraffin base, residue containing more than 5% paraffins. This crude consists primarily open chain compounds and furnishes low octane number, straight run gasoline and waxy lubricating oil stock. The mixed base or intermediate basement, residue containing 2 to 5% paraffins. This crude containing large quantity of both paraffinic and naphthalenic compounds and furnishes medium grade straight run gasoline and lubricating oils. Both wax and asphalt are found in these oils. Naphthalenic base, residue containing less than 2% paraffin. This crude containing a high percentage of cyclic naphthalenic compounds and furnishes relatively high octane number, straight run gasoline. The lubricating oil fraction must be solvent refined asphalt is present. Crude classification. The petroleum industry generally classifies crude oil by the geographic location it is produced in. Example, West Texas Intermediate, Brent or Oman. Its API gravity, an oil industry measures of density, and by its sulfur content. The crude may be referred to as sweet, that is less than 0.5% of sulfur. If it contains relatively little sulfur or sore, it is greater than 0.5% sulfur. If it contains substantial amount of sulfur. What is API gravity? The crude is classified as light, medium or heavy according its measured API gravity. API gravity is 141.5 divided by SG minus 131.5. So SG of oil is density of oil by density of water. Light crude oil is defined as having API gravity is higher than 31.1 degree API. That is called light crude oil. So students may note it down. This type of questions may ask gate related. Gate questions may ask them gate questions. So note it down. It is very important. And medium oil is defined as having API gravity between 22.3 and 31.1 degree API. Heavy oil is defined as having API gravity below 22.3 degree API. Oil with API gravity between 40 and 45 commands the highest prices above 45 degrees. API, the molar molecular chain, become shorter and less valuable refineries. Next, production of crude petroleum. Next topic we discussed about production of crude petroleum. In this before we can discuss about exploration of crude oil. The oil and gas. Oil and gas migrates out of its source rock and accumulates in overlying rocks. Some rocks like sandstone or limestone are permeable to oil and gas, which means that they can pass freely through them. Other rocks like clay or salt are impermeable, which means they block the upward passing of the hydrocarbon. In this, there are two type of rocks is available. One is permeable rock, another one is impermeable rock. So permeable rock when it is allowed to oil and gas flow freely passing. Impermeable means it blocks the upward passage of hydrocarbons. One of the most common way that oil and gas becomes trapped in pockets in the rack is where it is rises into a structural dome capped by impermeable rocks. The cap rock prevent the oil and gas escaping upwards. The buoyancy of the less dense hydrocarbons in the pore waters prevent them from sinking back down. This is an example of oil trap. Geologists who work for oil companies spend much of their time trying to identify underground traps. The permeable rocks then contains oil and gas. Within the oil trap are known as the reservoir rock. Reservoir rock have lots of interconnected holes called pores. This allow them to absorb the oil and gas like a sponge. These rocks can soak up a large amount of oil. This diagram shows oil and gas rise the crust of the fold. This is the oil and gas rise the crust of the hole. This is the oil well. Next, fault trap. Oil and gas collect the titled strata adjacent to the fault. Third one was the stalled dome trap. Oil and gas collect in strata on the flanks of the dome beneath salt. Next, stratonic trap. Oil and gas collect where the reservoir layer pinches it out. Next, exploration of crude oil continuation. Anti-slant trap. In some places, sedimentary beds are not horizontal, as they are when originally deposited, but have been bent by the force involved in mountaineering building. These bends, as we have seen, are called faults. You note it down. Maybe ask gate. An anticline is a type of fold with an arc-like shape. If the layer in the anticline include a source rock overlain in turn by a reservoir rock that overlain by a sealed rock, then we have a recipe for a oil reservoir. The oil and gas rises from the source rock, enter the reservoir rock, and rise to the crust of the anticline, where they are trapped by seal. Next, fault trap. A fault is a fracture on which there has been sliding. If the slip on the fault crashes and grinds the adjacent rock to make an impermeable layer along the fault, then oil and gas may migrate upward along bedding in the reservoir rock until they stop at the fault surface. Alternatively, a fault trap develops in the slip of the fault, juxtaposes an impermeable rock layer against the reservoir. Next, salt dome trap. In some sedimentary basins, sequence of strata contains a thick layer of salt deposited when the basins were first formed and the seawater covering the basin was shallow and very salty. Sandstone, shale, and limestone overlain the salt. The salt layer is not as dense as a sandstone or shale, so it is buoyant and tends to rise up slowly through the overlying strata. Once the salt starts to rise, the weight of the surrounding strata sequences the salt out of the layer and off into the growing buffered salt dump. As the dump rises, it bends up the adjacent layer of the sedimentary rock, oil and gas in reservoir rock. Layers migrate upward until they are trapped against the boundary of the salt dome. a salt layer is not permeable. In a static trap, a tightened reservoir bed pinches out things and disappears, or pits dip between two impermeable layers. Oil and gas migrating upward along the bed accumulate at the pinch out. Exploration of the crude oil. This diagram shows the survey ship. This is the source of shock waves, air gun, and hydrophones are using. This is the seabed and sedimentary rock layer. This is the seawater. And then uncertainty, the path of reflected waves are going. We can identify the crude oil places. This is the impermeable rock. This is the water. This is the porous reservoir rock. This is identified as a oil present in that underground, under the sea. Seismic surveying is being the form of for the most widely used and important method of gaining an impression of the subsurface. Seismic surveys can be acquired at sea as well as on land. The marine method is the most common in petroleum exploration. The sound waves, effectively the same as seismic P waves produced by earthquakes, pass through the water column and into the underlying rock layers. Some waves travel down until they reach a layer with distinctively different seismic properties, from which they may be reflected in roughly the same way that light reflects off a mirror. For this reason, the layers are called seismic reflector. The reflected waves rebounded and traveled back to the surface reservoir or hydrophones, receiving them at a different time from any waves that have traveled there directly. Their exact time of travel will depend on the speed that sound travels through the rock. It is seismic velocity. Other waves may pass through the first layer and travel deeper to the second or third prominent reflector. All of you know, listen, this is very important. Maybe sometimes asked for gate questions. If they are eventually reflected back to the hydrocarbon hydrophones, they will arrive later than waves reflected from upper horizons. The hydrocarbons therefore defect bundles of seismic waves arriving at different times becomes they have traveled by different routes through the rock cones. Production of crude oil. A potential oil trap is called as prospect. Once prospect has been identified, the next stage is to drill a hole into the top of the trap to see if it contains oil and gas. It is incredibly expensive to drill a hole. When exploratory drilling is successful, more wells are drilled to determining the size and extent of the field. Wells drilled to quantity, the hydrocarbon reserves found are called outstep or appraisal wells. The appraisal stage aims to evaluate the size and nature of the reservoir to determine the number of confirming appraisal wells required and whether any further seismic work is necessary. Having established the size of the oil field, the subsequent wells drilled are called development or production wells. A core which contains oil and gas is called as well. The oil and gas is under considerable pressure in the earth crust. So once a well is drilled into the reservoir rock, the oil and gas rapidly rises to the surface. However, as more and more oil and gas comes out of the well, eventually the pressure drops and flow slows down. To get the remainder of the oil and gas out of the reservoir rock, a second hole is drilled adjacent to the first. Hot water or steam are pumped down the hole and oil forces the oil and gas till trapped in the rock up and original value. This technique is known as enhanced oil recovery. Once the oil and gas have been extracted, it must be safely transported from the well to the refinery, where it will be processed. Oil is usually transported from the well to the refinery using pipelines. These may be stretched over land or be laid over the seabed. Another way that oil and gas are transported is by means of massive oil tankers. These gigantic vessels can carry up to 500,000 tons of oil. Too many dry holes means too many lose their jobs. Production of crude oil. This diagram shows for the production of crude oil. So in this drilling machine is casing drill pipe and cement drill bit. Drill pipe rock. This is the reservoir pit, swivel, mud gas separator. This is for fuel tanks, power generating plant. This is for mud pits. This for mud pumps, accumulated unit, tank wheels, traveling block, rotary holes, standard pipe, ground block, drill cooler. This is for rotary table, galley bussing. Next, this diagram shows there are several type of drilling rig, ranging from relatively small one as the developed on land that can be dismantled and transported by truck or helicopter to large offshore units. This figure B2D that are capable of working in the range of water depths and sea conditions. Next, the production of crude oil is continuation. An offshore jackup ring is a barge with latex steel leg that can be raised and lowered. Figure B. It is towed into the position by tanks and its legs are lowered to the seabed before the barge is raised 10 to 30 mm out of the water to create a stable drilling platform. They usually operate in water depth up to 200 meters. Drilling in greater water depths requires a floating unit, and the semi-submersible rig is the most common and versatile type. The working platform is supported on vertical columns that are attached to submerged plantons. Once in position, the rig is anchored to the seabed and pontons are floated with water to submerge them beneath the wave level. The lower the pontons are beneath the water, the less likely they are to be affected by the wave action. This makes them stable in rough seas. Some semi-permersible rigs have computer-controlled positioning propellers rather than anchors to keep them in position, and they can be used in water depths down to 1000 meters or more. Drill ships. Reassemble conventional ships and they can move easily around the world. Figure D. They have two dynamic positioning that allows them to stay on location with remarkable accuracy in all but the most severe storms. Since they are not ballasted, they can be unstable in high seas, but their advantage is that they can drill in water depths in excess of 2000 meters. This flow sheet or block diagram shows typical crude oil processing. The production of facility process, the hydrocarbon fluid separates oil and gas water. The oil must usually be free dissolved gas before export. Similarly, the gas must be stabilized and free of liquids and unwanted components such as hydrocarbon, sulfide, and carbon dioxide. Any water produced is returned before disposal. The block diagram shows this is for producing well, onshore or offshore. In that, we are causing three-phase separation, that is oil, water, gas. Oil, it goes to oil stabilization heater treatment, and that stabilized crude oil is passed to oil storage and loading facility. It is passed to pipeline, onshore and offshore. In before that, we goes to low pressure gas, in sales gas compressors, that is glycol dehydration, that goes to gas sales pipeline. Three-phase separation on the produced water disposal to gas, gas to flash gas compressor. Refinery products, gas fraction, that is natural gas, light gases. Natural gas, LPG, light gases, C1, C2, off gases, H2, H2S, SO2. Light ends, naphtha, gasoline, kerosene, jet fuel. 3. Intermediate distillates, heavy fuel oils, diesel oils, gas oils. 4th one, heavy distillates. mineral oils, waxes, lubricating oils. Residues: lubricating fuel oils, greases, asphalt, petrol. Sixth one is byproduct: ammonia, detergent, sulfur and its derivatives. Refinery products: fuels, motor, gasoline, diesel and distillate fuel oil, jet fuel, residual fuel oil, kerosene and coke. The chemical industry feedstocks: naphtha, ethane, propane, butane, ethylene, propylene, butylene, butadiene, benzene, toluene and xylene. Finished non-fuel products: solvents, lubricating oil, greases, petroleum wax, petroleum jelly, asphalt and coke. The next, these products are used as a primary input to vast number of products: fertilizer, pesticides, paint, waxes, thinners, solvent, cleaning fluids, detergents, refrigerants, antifreezes, resins, sealers, insulators, latex, rubber compounds, hard plastics, plastic sheeting and synthetic. These are the refinery, different type of refinery products. So students, listen carefully and note it down. Maybe sometimes asked this type of questions in GATE. Next, refinery products. In petroleum fractions, there are many. First one is light gases. The hydrocarbon range is C2 to C4. The approximate boiling point is minus 90 degree to 1. Gasoline, light and heavy, C4 to C10, 1 to 200 degrees Celsius, minus 1 to 200 degrees Celsius. Naphthalene, light, heavy, C4 to C11, minus 1 to 205. Jet fuel, C9 to C14, 150 to 255. And diesel fuel, C11 to C16, 205 to 220. Light gas oil, the hydrocarbon range is C14 to C18. The temperature boiling range is 255 to 315. Heavy gas oil, C18 to C28. This is C315 to 425. Wax, C318 to 3C36, 315 to 500. Lubricating oil, greater than C25, greater than 400. C28 to C55, 425 to 600. This is greater than 55. C55, that is greater than 600 degree Celsius. These slide shows different type of refinery product and the hydrocarbon range C1, C2 to C55 and approximate boiling range is minus 90 degree to greater than 600 degree Celsius. Next, important characterization of properties in petroleum. In that, first one is temperature boiling point, TBP. In petroleum refining, we deal with boiling point range. For example, suppose that we take a sample of heating oil and place it in a heated container at atmospheric pressure. The temperature at which the first vapor is formed is called the initial boiling point. This corresponds to the bubble point of the mixture of specific chemical compounds. If we continue to heat the sample, more and more material is vaporized. The 5% point in the wave temperature at which 5% of original sample has vaporized. Liquid volume percentage are traditionally used. The 95% point is the temperature at which 95% liquid volume percentage of the original sample has vaporized. The final boiling point is the temperature at which all of the liquid disappears. There are three types of boiling point analysis. First one is ASTM D86 Engler and ASTM D158 Seybold and true boiling point TBP. The ASTM analysis is easier and faster to run. The TBP analysis gives more detailed information about the certain cutoff crude. Next, this students noted down this graph. It is very important. Maybe sometimes using this graph we can occur in some GATE questions. Related GATE questions comes in this type of graph. So this is the graph for temperature boiling point TBP curves. In that, x-axis volume percentage distilled, y-axis temperature. So TBP curve, in top of that layer is gas oil, and in that now in upper heating oil, in below jet fuel, in that below naphtha and light fuel ends. The TBP plot of the crude gives and estimated the amount of each petroleum cut in the coil. The boiling point range of each product from the pipe still is known on the horizontal lines. For example, the boiling point ranges of jet fuel in the crude is 280 to 460 Fahrenheit by reading of the volume percentage at this temperature, 70 to 40 volume percentage respectively. Petroleum cuts from TBP curve for crude, heavy naphtha steam, which is used for production of gasoline. It has ASTM 5% and 9.5% of boiling point of 150 and 375 Fahrenheit respectively. A diesel product is produced from the bottom of the stripper. It has ASTM 5% and 95% of boiling point of the 489 and 640 Fahrenheit respectively. Atmospheric gasoline, AGO, with ASTM 5% and 95% of boiling point of 589 and 782 Fahrenheit respectively. At continuation, TBP curve continuation. In the distillation of petroleum fraction, separation is expression in terms of gaps and overlaps. To note down, this point is very important, may be sometimes asked for gate questions. These terms refers to the difference between the 95% of boiling point of the lighter product and the 5% boiling point of the adjacent mixed behavior product. If there were perfect separation of the petroleum cuts, the final boiling point of a lighter product would be equal to the initial boiling point of the next heavier product, but separation is not perfect. The range is 95% to 5% first is used as a measure fractionation. Next property is annealing point. Annealing point to determine a rough estimate of aromatic content of oils. The annealing point for a hydrocarbon or petroleum fraction is defined as the minimum temperature at which equal volumes of liquid hydrocarbon and aniline are miscible. Aniline is an aromatic compound with a structure of benzene molecule where one atom of hydrocarbon, hydrogen, is replaced by the minus NH2 group, C6H5NH2. The aniline point is important in characterization of petroleum fraction and analysis of molecular type. An aniline point is also used as a characterization parameter for the ignition quality of diesel fuel. This is very important, all of you note it down. Next, with a hydrocarbon group, aniline point increases with the molecular weight of hydrocarbon number, but the same carbon number, it increases from the aromatic to paraffin hydrocarbon. Aromatic have very low aniline point in comparison with paraffin, since aniline itself is an aromatic compound and it has better acidity with aromatic hydrocarbon. Generally, oil with higher aniline point have lower aromatic content. Next property is vapor rate vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is measure of volatility and it is used in the phase equilibrium calculation such as flask, bubble point or dew point pressure calculation in order to determine the state of the fluid in a reservoir or a separate vapor from liquid. It is needed in calculation of equilibrium ratios for operation and design of distillation absorber stripping columns in refineries. It is also needed in determination of the amount of hydrocarbon losses from the storage facilities and their presence of air. So students, listen carefully. Vapor pressure is properly that represents ignition characteristics of the fuel. For example, rate vapor pressure, that is RVP, and boiling range of gasoline governs ease of starting engine. Engine warm-up and rate of acceleration, mileage, economy, and tendency toward vapor lock. Rate vapor pressure. Rate vapor pressure is the absolute pressure extracted by a mixture at 37.8 degrees Celsius, 311 K or 100 Fahrenheit at a vapor to liquid volume ratio of 4. The RVP is one of the most important properties of gasoline and jet fuel and it is used as a characterization of blending of product. RVP is also a useful parameter for estimation of losses from storage tanks during filling or dining. Octane number, next parameter. Octane number is parameter defined to characterize antinog characters. So students, note it down, this very important. Characterize antinog characteristics of fuel, that is called gasoline or spark ignition engines. Octane number is measures fuel ability. What is the use of octane number means? It is measured fuel ability to reset auto ignition during compression and prior to ignition. Higher octane number fuel have better engine performance. Next, the octane number of fuel is measured based on two references hydrocarbon of N-heptane with an assigned octane number of 0 and iso-octane 2,2,4 trimethyl pentane with assigned octane number of 100. The mixture of 70 volume percentage is iso-octane and 30 volume percentage is N-heptane has a octane number of 70. Generally, isoparaffin have higher octane number than normal paraffin. Naphthalenes have relatively higher octane number than do corresponding paraffins, and aromatic have very high octane numbers. The octane number of fuel can be improved by adding tetramethyl lead TEL or methyl retroributyl method MTB. Use of lead to improve octane number of fuel is limiting in many industrial countries because of environmental hazards. In these countries, MTBE is used for octane number improvement. However, there are problems of groundwater contamination with BTME. Values of the octane number measured without any additives are called clear octane number. You all have been noted down what is clear octane number means. Values of octane number measured without any additive is called clear octane number. Next, what is CT number and diesel index? In that, for diesel index, the fuel must have characteristic and favor auto ignition. The ignition delay period can be evaluated by the fuel characterization factor called CT number. The behavior of diesel fuel is measured by comparing its performance with two pure hydrocarbons, N-cetane or N-hexane. There is N-C16H34, which is given the number 100, and a methyl naphthalene, which is given the CT number 0. In practice, heptamethylamine, a branched isomer N-cetane with CT number of 15 is used instead of methyl naphthalene. Therefore, in practice, the cetane number is defined as CN volume percentage N-cetane plus 0.15 volume percentage HMN. Flash point is very useful property for the safety of handling volatile fuels and petroleum products, especially in summer seasons. In flash point, the notation is TF. For a hydrocarbon or fuel is the minimum temperature at which all of you noted down, sometimes it may ask it as the gate questions. The minimum temperature at which vapor pressure of hydrocarbon is sufficient to produce the vapor needed for the spontaneous ignition of the hydrocarbon with the presence of an external source, that is spark or flame. From this definition, it is clear that hydrocarbon with higher vapor pressure, lighter compounds have lower flash points. Generally, flash point increases with an increasing boiling point. Flash point is an important parameter for safety consideration, especially during the storage and transportation of volatile petroleum products, that is LPG, light naphtha, gasoline, in a high temperature environment. The surrounding temperature around the storage tank should always be less than the flash point of the fuel to avoid possibility of ignition. Flash point is used as an indication of the fire and explosion potential of petroleum product. Note, flash points should not be mistaken with fire point, which is defined as the minimum temperature at which the hydrocarbon will continue to burn for at least 5 years after being ignited by a flame. Next, 4 point. The pour point of petroleum fraction is the lowest temperature at which the oil will pour or flow when it is cooled without stirring under standard cooling condition. All of you note it down. This is very important point. Sometimes it may ask for gate related questions. What is pour point? It is a petroleum fraction of lowest temperature at which the oil will pour or flow when it is cooled without stirring under standard cooling conditions. Pour point represents the lowest temperature at which oil can be stored and still capable of flowing under gravity. Pour point is one of the low temperature characteristics of heavy fractions. When temperature is less than pour point of petroleum products cannot be stored or transferred through a pipeline. Smoke point. Smoke point is a characteristic of aviation turbine fuel and kerosene and indicates the tendency of fuel to burn with a smoky flame. The higher amount of aromatics in a fuel causes a smoky characteristics for the flame and energy loss due to thermal radiation. It is exposed in millimeters and a high smoke point indicates a fuel with low smoke producing tendency. SP, that is equal to 1.65 into minus 0.0112 in the expire minus 8.7 into 100 divided by 0.61 XP into 0.3392 XN and 13.518 XA. Where, what is SP? SP is the smoke point by IP test method in mm, and XP, XN and XA are the fraction of paraffin, naphthalene and aromatic content of kerosene. Cloud point. What is cloud point? All of you note it down. This is very important. The cloud point is lowest temperature at which wax crystals begin to form by gradual cooling under standard conditions. Maybe asked this type of questions in GATE. You note it down. So cloud point means the lowest temperature at which wax crystals begin to form, underline this word, by a gradual cooling under saturated conditions. At this temperature, the oil becomes cloudy and first particle of wax crystal are absorbed. Cloud point is another cold characteristic of petroleum oil under low temperature conditions and increases the molecular weight of oil increases. Cloud points are measured for oil and that contain paraffin in the form of wax and therefore for light fractions such as naphtha or gasoline, no cloud point data are reported. Cloud points usually occur at 4 to 5 degrees Celsius above the 4 point, although the temperature differential could be in the range of 0 to 10 degrees Celsius. Petroleum conversion process. This is our next topic. There are many type of conversion processes are available that are pyrolysis, cracking, reforming, polymerization, isomerization, and alkalization. In that, we are discussing about first process. Process in the petroleum refinery industry. There are many processes. First one is separation, conversion, treating, blending, auxiliary. Separation. What is separation? This the process involved separating the different fraction of hydrocarbon compound that make up crude oil based on their boiling point differences. Additional processing of these fraction is usually needed to produce final product to be sold with the market. In that associated operations, atmospheric distillation, vacuum distillation, light end recovery, that is gas processing. Atmospheric distillation unit. What is the use? Distill crude oil into fractions. Next, vacuum distillation unit. Further distills residual bottom after atmospheric distillation unit. So note it down, these are the unit operations: separation, conversion, treating, blending, and auxiliary for refinery industry. Next, what is conversion? Include process used to break down large chain molecules into smaller chain one by heating using catalysis. This is what is the purpose of using this conversion process: to increase the octane value of the product. Associated operations: cracking, thermal and catalytical, reforming, alkalization, polymerization, isomerization, coking and bisbaking. These are the different types of unit operations involved the conversion of process of crude oil. Next, there are different types of conversion processes are available. In that first one, pyrolysis. What is pyrolysis? When a hydrocarbon is heated at very high temperature, thermal cracking occurs. When coal is used for heating, that process is called pyrolysis. So students, all of you note it down. Maybe sometimes asked for this topic in under some GATE questions. You all of you listen carefully and note it down. Catalytic reformer unit. It is used to convert the naphtha boiling range molecules into higher octane reformer, that is reformer product, The reformate has higher octane and aromatic and cyclic hydrocarbons. An important byproduct of reformate is hydrogen released during the catalyst reaction. The hydrogen is used either in the hydrotreater or the hydrocracker. Fluid catalytic cracker unit upgrades heavier fractions into lighter, more valuable products. Hydrocracker unit uses hydrogen to upgrade heavier fractions into lighter, more valuable products. Disc braking unit upgrades heavy residual oils by thermally cracking them into lighter, more valuable, reduced viscosity products. Alkaline unit produces high octane component for gasoline blending. Demineralization unit converts olefin into higher octane gasoline blending compounds. For example, butylenes can be demineralized into isooctane, which may be subsequently be hydrogenated to form isooctane. There are also other uses for dimerization. Isomerization unit converts linear molecule to higher octane branched molecules for blending into gasoline or feed to alkylation unit. Next, coking unit. That is delayed coking or fluid coking or flexi coker. Causes a very heavy residue oil into gasoline and diesel fuel, leaving petroleum coke as a residue product. This diagram shows fluid catalytic cracking. It is introduced in the year of 1942. It is excellent integration of reactor with catalyst regeneration for the high thermal efficiency. It is very important to increase the octane value of crude oil operation. That is called fluid catalytic cracking. So, CO boiler and reactor, regenerator, fractionator, there are four unit operations are available in this flow sheet. In this reactor, we are adding feed. The temperature is 300 degree Fahrenheit. It rises up to 1000 degree Fahrenheit in the riser, and the catalyst, regenerated catalyst, feed into that reactor. The products are, we are obtaining, it passed to fractionator. Based on the boiling point difference, the products were separated. Top product is gas. In next, the intermediate products are gasoline, light hydrocarbon, heavy hydrocarbon, decondensed oil. In regenerator, what will happen? 1300 to 1400 degree Fahrenheit, the catalyst will be regenerated in the presence of air. The regenerated catalyst fed into that reactor. Again, that reaction will take place. The coked catalyst, again, it passed to regenerator system. The flue gasser passed to carbon boiler. Next, in fluid catalytic cracking, is a fluidized bed or fluid bed of catalyst particles is brought into contact with the gaseous oil fed along with the injected steam at the entrance. It is called riser of the reactor. The hot catalyst particle coming from the regenerated unit, it evaporates the feed gas oil contact in the riser, and then it cracking starts. The gas oil vapors and catalyst particle move upward in the reactor. These are will taken in the reaction or reactor. Next, the temperature of the catalytic particle drops as the evaporation of gas oil, and the endothermic cracking reactions proceed during the upward movement. Cracking reaction also deposits significant amount of coke on the catalyst, leading to the deactivation of the catalyst. After removing the adsorbed hydrocarbons by steam stripping, the coked catalyst is sent to the regeneration unit to burn off the coke with air. The heat is released from the burning the coke deposit. It increases the temperature of the catalyst particle that are returned to the riser to complete the cycle. The burning of two rejected carbon coke in the regenerator provides the energy necessary for cracking without much loss, thus increasing the thermal efficiency of the process. The cracking products are sent to the fractionator or recovery after they are separated from the catalyst particles of upper section of the reactor. In the reactor, the cracking reactions initiate on the activation sites of the catalyst with formation of carbonation and the subsequent ionic chain. Students, listen carefully. Ionic chain reaction produce branched alkanes and aromatic components to constitute the crack it or cracked gasoline with high octane number, high olefins, gasolines, and slurry oil that are sent to the fractionator. The carbon-rich byproduct catalytic cracking termed as coke. It deposits on catalyst surface and blocks the activate sites. Fluid catalytic cracking is considered a carbon rejection process because of the coke deposited on the catalyst surface and eventually burned off or heated is rich in carbon and thus enable the production of large quantities of light distillate, that is crackate, in the process without addition of this hydrogen. So all of you listen carefully, and some of the questions may come in this topic for GATE. Okay, we will discuss about next topic in next class. Today class, next class. So thank you.